Hey guys, so today I'm going to show you all the things that I got in my recent order from Itsy Bitsy. It's a craft store with a lot of variety in India. They have online as well as a physical shop. Of course, I got it from their online store. You can check their website as well as their Instagram account. Both will be linked down below. This is not a sponsored video. I just love this store and I bought many goodies this time, and that is why I'm doing this video. So I hope you enjoy this. There are a lot of things that I got, so I'm not sure from where to start. Let's start here. And half of the things I'm not even sure what I'll be using for. But yeah, let's see. You can follow me on Instagram. I'll be posting there I usually post there whatever I make mostly on my stories. So yeah, these are wooden discs and I never tried anything like this. I never bought MDF stuff and or wooden stuff for crafting, so that is why I thought, you know, I could buy these and use some acrylic colors and try my hand at some cute little things. So yeah, then this is just a cute small home decor piece, and it's a wooden hanging and I really love this coat, that is why I bought this. Then I bought these four wooden small frames. In this I will either put printouts or my own art. So if you know me from Instagram, you must have seen I'm decorating one of my rooms. So I'll be putting those on that. And these are sticks, like wooden sticks in two different sizes. The reason why I bought this is because I wanted to make hangings for my room, or just sending them in happy mail. I recently made a wall hanging using stars and just paper, so that was really cute. I did not have anything like this to make a wall hanging. I'm not sure for what else they like people use this, but I wanted something like this in my stash. And then this is MDF, just circular thing, which I'll use for painting using acrylic colors. So these are the two sizes. There's one more bigger size. This is a rectangular piece with these shaped edges, shaped corners. And then this is a bigger piece. I think this is 12 by 12. It is quite heavy. You can lift it with one hand. Then let's start with these smaller pieces. So these I bought for hanging those MDF boards, or maybe for something else, but mostly for those boards and other frames. Then this is also for hanging frames or dishes which don't have any hooks on the back. So this was really nice. I bought two of these. And then these small nails. It is written as metal decor pieces, but I'm not sure. These are definitely nails. I don't know where I'll be using these, but yeah, these are very tiny, so I can easily use them. Then some clips. Because yeah, now I remembered, I was planning to make either the round one or this one to have these clips, so that, you know, I can put pictures here or my artwork or something like that. Then yeah, let me show you. Okay, let me show you this. I never had these glass bottles, so I thought of buying these. I have a lot of sequins and sparkle powder, so and beads as well. So I thought it will be great to use those things in this. then let's see these sticky notes. I did not know they had sticky notes, and these are so cute. And I am not sure if they've written the cost, made in China. But I don't remember the cost, but they were not that expensive. And they have so many sticky notes, and they are so different, you know, the designs are different and so pretty. I'm not sure about the quality, as in glue wise, how well they stick, and if you can, you know, change their position with glue being intact. I'll let you know that maybe on Instagram. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below. Then this is another sticky note. Look how many they have in one, and they're so pretty. I love their cover also. Once the sticky notes are over, which I think it will take a while, I'll be using the cover. Then let's start with these art journal supplies. So this is alcohol blending solution. I have never used this, but I do have some alcohol inks from their shop only, I guess. And I think this will come handy while using them. I want to buy the Yuko paper, I think it is called. I have used alcohol inks on clear transparent sticker paper. It worked quite well. Let's try the other paper, which is actually made for for alcohol inks. And this is for, you know, I don't know, blender, I guess you call this, for inks. And these are just extra felt patches. These are not for this one, I guess, but I could probably use for with this, maybe, because it has like a Velcro here. It has a Velcro here, so maybe I can use this with this. I'm not sure. Then let's see these. I am really loving this setup to show all these things, not for planning maybe, because it's at a lower height, but it really works well with this camera stand. So these are just some cutouts or die cuts made using watercolors. So I do have a cutting machine, but it does not work, the blade does not work well with watercolor paper. That is why I thought of buying these ready-made ones. I also saved time cutting these. So yeah, I think these are 100 pieces, yeah, as you can see here. And this is really good because I can, you know, use my own watercolors, and I don't need to, I can use my own colors, the shade that I want. I use a lot of pink and blue and yellow. So in, you know, if there were other colors in this pack, if it was already colored, the other colors would have got wasted. But this is not the case. I can just, you know, use my own colors and give them different shades and all that. I hope you get my point. So yeah, then these are some swirls and borders. These are, I don't know, what do you call them, but the same thing basically, shaped rectangles and squares, circle and butterfly, same thing. Then these are already printed, and I am sure I'll be having fun painting these. This is kind of a frame. Really love these. And then I got some glitter paper. This is 6x6. I really love using glitter paper. I will show these later on. It's just a double-sided sticky tape. Then some more glitter paper, A4 size, in different shade colors. Okay, let me show you these things. I'm not yet sure how to use these, but basically these are used to hang, yeah, as you can see here, to, you know, rest some things on these hinges or these things. I'll have to figure out how to use these, but yeah, just sort of trying these in case I ever need. Then this is a really big shadow box. It had a glass here. Let me try and show you this. Okay, so it had a glass here, but it, like, this corner of it broke in transit, and that is why I had to remove that glass. Like, it was already kind of removed, I guess it had just come off from the edges. So yeah, that glass is not there here right now. I have emailed them about it. I'm not sure what's gonna happen. I told them that I don't need a replacement because it's quite a huge box and I don't have space to, you know, put two big boxes on my walls. I will just use it as it is. Maybe, yes, there will be some problem with the dust entering this cloth, but yeah, let's see. And then that's another 12 by 12 big box. That's a normal frame, not a box, sorry, that's just a frame, which is still in the plastic. I haven't removed the cover. And yeah, I wanted this to put pretty pattern paper inside, because I have so many pattern papers and they're so pretty, but I did not have a 12 by 12 size frame, so that is why I got this, and it has a nice white border. Then now these are just markers. It has this tip, yeah, this tip like a sketch pen, and it writes really well. It's dark, I'll show that to you. And then this fine tip, even the fine tip writes very well. Then this is my first ever paint marker. I have used this here, not yet on clear paper, but it's quite good. As per the instruction, you do have to shake it a bit before the first time usage, and then, you know, just tap the tip and then it works fine. So this is butter paper which I got to make pockets and to use it like a vellum. I won't be printing on this, of course, but yeah, I can make my own art. And I think this is Tomb of Furinosuke, I guess I'm saying that correctly, pen. This is that thick paint marker, and I guess this one is this pen. So all these pens write quite well on this paper as well. So the paper as well as the pens are good. Then I got these acrylic colors. All three are from different brands. I was not specific about the brand, I just wanted these colors. This, however, is like a typical green. I thought it would be a little bit different, but it is almost like a poster dark green color. That's a different color. I think that's the watercolor that I had, I guess, yeah. And I like this color. It is, yeah, as it says, yellow ochre. It is almost the same, as you can see. I'll just get my book in which I have used these colors. And then I love camel colors, and especially the acrylic colors, artist's acrylic colors. They are really good. I like the effect of this one much better than both of these brands, although I like their products as well, but I really love these acrylic colors and even the poster colors. They are cheap and good for beginners. Okay, so this is the mixed media paper that I use from the brand Bristow. I think this is an Indian brand, and I love their papers. They have one, I'm not sure how 100% cotton or what, I'm not sure, but that one is cold pressed watercolor paper. They have this blue design or color here in the packaging, and that's really, I really love that watercolor paper. And then this is artist's mixed media paper, and even this is good. I mean, it's quite sturdy or thick, if you or hard, if you can say. And it takes watercolors as well as any other media well. I have used gesso also on this, modeling paste, stencils, inks, everything works really well on this. You can find it on Amazon as well as on their website. And it's quite affordable for the quality that they're giving. This is the green. This one. Then these are just older. Then this is this yellow color, ochre color. It is almost like the poster color, with camel poster color, but a little bit thicker, you can see, because it's acrylic. And yeah, it's nice. Not a little bit more on yellow side than brown. Then I love this shade. I mean, they have this camel acrylic, artist acrylic colors. They have such good shades, and they are really good. I have more of these, I think white and a pink shade as well. So this is certain, like, how, see how well it spreads. And I mean, look at the difference. So it spreads really, almost like watercolor. Sorry. So yeah. And you can get light as well as dark shade very easily, as you can see here. And just look at this green color. It's so nice. It's, I already had, I actually thought it must be a little bit lighter, somewhat like olive green, but this is a watercolor that I have, and I really love this as well. But I like this shade a lot. So yeah, these are the colors. And now let's see these decoupage napkins. I have one or two which I haven't yet used. I am holding those because I had not found much variety that time, so I was holding them, but now is the time to use them because I got a lot of these pretty ones. So I love these peonies. Just I guess these are peonies, I'm not sure, but so pretty. They look even prettier in person because the colors are really nice than bright and dark. Just look at this, so pretty. I had ordered similar floral plants, but this they had some problem with this, so they gave other one. So pretty. The colors are almost like how you can see on the screen, at least on my camera screen. So pretty. So I'm going to have fun using all these. And if you want to see what I create using them, follow me on my Instagram, linked below in the description. I mostly share almost every day on my Instagram stories. And I'm not that regular on my posting on my Instagram feed because it takes a little more effort. But yeah, you can follow me definitely for my stories. I'll be posting how I use these. Thanks for watching. Bye bye. Any questions, leave me in the comments. Bye.